Welcome to Goobertown Hobbies, my name is Brent. Today, we're going to be doing some light conversion to make a legendary Warhammer character. The best part is that all the bits we need are included in this one Warhammer Underworlds kit. I've been working on a big Slaves to Darkness army, and I'm trying to share the most interesting moments from this project. Warriors of Chaos is a faction that goes back decades, and there have been several generations of these models. A lot of my army is based on this relatively new Start Collecting box. The new generation of Chaos Warriors is really cool, but unfortunately, they're all monopose models. There are 10 variants in this box. The larger the army grows, the more twins it's going to contain. It was exciting when this Khagra's Ravagers Underworld set came out with 3 new warrior variants. Variety is good. Even better, one of those 3 models has a Slambo pose. A few years ago, Games Workshop put out a redesigned Slambo model as an homage to the old school Pewter Chaos Warriors. This Slambo model is out of production now, and it was resin anyway, so I think it would be cool to make a plastic one. This is also a great excuse to paint a green character. Here's the warband as it was meant to be with no conversions. I'm working on painting up one set of this team in the same color scheme as the rest of my army. I'm using this first copy to get some nice close-up shots of my paint scheme. In the summer, I'll be donating this Underworlds warband to the Nova Open charity raffle, so stay tuned for that. Of course I bought more than one copy of this warband, so we're gonna do a conversion to make a Slambo. This character of Kragan is already pretty close to Slambo. He looks awesome. Let's make a few tweaks and paint him green. The plastic bits fit together as a front half, a back half, 2 arm pieces that get sandwiched in between, and a head that goes on top. I want to replace the sword with an axe, so I'm deciding whether the cut goes at the wrist or at the handle of the weapon just above the hand. If I decide to cut at the wrist, it'll be easier to do before I glue the bits together and that armored vambrace gets in the way. On the front half, I decided to remove the giant shoulder spike. Slambo doesn't have one of these. The original Slambo also doesn't have a scaly animal pelt or a shield slung across his back. But I've found that conversions are more about getting the silhouette right than anything else. I took a look at my bits collection for axes and for helmets. I actually have several options for both of these, but I do like the idea of using bits from this one model kit, so I guess I'll use the axe from good old Razik. For making reasonably smooth cuts, I have this pair of clippers from Red Grass Games. They're kinda small, so I don't use them for clipping sprues, but they are extremely sharp, and they make clean cuts, so I use them for this sort of thing. I cut both the sword and the axe just above the hand. I did a bit of sanding so that they would be flush at the correct angle. Then I glued the bits together with plastic cement. Moving on to the head. Slambo has a horned helm where the 2 horns come together and are joined with a tiny skull. There are several good possibilities from other Chaos Warrior and Chaos Knight kits. But again, we have the choice to use bits from this one model kit, so how about we just use the helmet from Razik? It fits the requirements, and it looks pretty good. And there we go. This is a modern Slambo. Let's figure out how to get that sweet Slambo green. At times like these, I pull out my test marines. They've been painted often, and it's their time to shine yet again. I've got a few color recipes in mind that might work, so let's prime over these marines and test out some greens. Slambo has a shine to him. I need to decide whether to do this with a metallic green or non-metallics. A little while back, I got this set of colored metallics in the mail from Army Painter, and one in particular looks like it might be the right green for the job. I tried brushing it on, and I really did not like it. This is not for Slambo. Out of curiosity, I went through a few of the other colors. I really don't know what I'd use these for, but hey, this is why we have test marines. I also tried putting that metallic green through an airbrush, this is a little bit better, but I'm gonna keep looking for that true Slambo green. Now I wanna try some translucent green inks. For some of the marines, I undercoated with black and did a white zenithal highlight. For others, I undercoated with bright metallic silver. I even tried adding some shadows to the metallic undercoat with some Payne's Gray. Then I added a layer or two of green ink all over everything. I found that it was easy to go too heavy over the metallic and lose a lot of that sheen. Not necessarily a bad thing, just good to know. Many of the marines with a silver undercoat ended up looking similar to the marines with the black and white undercoat. After much experimenting, I wound up with a smorgasbord of green test models, and I picked a favorite. Those marines did their job, and they will patiently wait until they are called upon to serve again. And now it's Slambo's turn. After a black undercoat, I sprayed on a white highlight. I'm lighting the model up from above. If I do it right, this step will ensure that we have some nice shadows and highlights on the finished model. I mixed up 5 parts olive green and 1 part emerald green, and gave Slambo a few thin coats. I want this just thick enough to really register as green, while still keeping some of those dark to light transitions. After the green, I loaded up with pure yellow ink and hit Slambo from above to pop those highlights a bit. He's holding those axes out to the side. It was pretty easy to give them a smooth coat of metallic steel. I like to take care of this with an airbrush whenever possible, so that I don't end up with brush strokes in the middle of those big flat axe heads. As a final step with the airbrush, I applied 2 thin coats of satin varnish to protect the delicate ink layers. Let's take out some brushes and paint Slambo. His cape is black. The official Slambo doesn't have a cape, so I don't want this to draw attention. His boots are dark brown, and a few other bits are too. For variety, I used a lighter brown on his belt. It's always nice to have a few shades of brown handy, especially for fantasy models with a lot of leather. These models have some spikes and metal filigree. I painted these with gunmetal steel. The box art for Slambo has gold accent colors. I will use a bit of gold, but the steel will help to tie him in with the rest of my army. For the horns, I'm starting with a very light gray. I find this to be a bit smoother than a lot of the bone colors that I own. I used Nuln Oil Wash to line the cracks in his armor, and that includes the features on his helmet. Normally I do 2 passes on the eye holes to get them nice and dark. For the scaly pelt, I'm treating it with 2 layers of Guillemot Flesh contrast paint. I want it to still be green so that it feels like Slambo, but it can't be an identical color to the green paint on his armor. The contrast paint does a good job at tweaking the green base coat to look like the hide of a big lizard. Later, I gave the pelt a dry brush with sickly green. The horns get some brown wash. I like that these horns have a bit of texture on them to catch the wash. Trying to paint smooth horns always vexes me. That strong tone goes in a few other places too, like here on the belt. Slambo is a fancy man, so let's trade in a bit of that steel and silver for some gold. Green and gold looks great, and it's also pure Slambo. Let's take a quick break to set up a base. I've been on a kick of trying to make cobblestone bases for a ruined city. I've got some epoxy sculpt here, and I'm gonna mash it with a rock to give it some rock texture. I made this stamp here out of plastic card and foam board. This just makes nice little rows. I still haven't found a pre-made stamp or texture roller that I really like, so for now I'm making my own. Next, I come in with my hobby knife to cut in the brickwork. I've appreciated all of the suggestions that I've gotten, but I still don't have a perfect way to make cobblestones. I'm getting there though, bit by bit. As a final layer of texture, I gently roll some tin foil over the base. This should make some pockmarks that'll play nicely with washes. Once the epoxy sculpt was cured, I added some texture paste and embedded some sand, rocks, and little chunks of 3D printed debris. This is rubble on the streets of a conquered city. Slambo is supposed to be on this big 40mm base, so I wanted to build it up a bit and make it more interesting. I actually made two bases like this. It's good practice, and I'll mount Slambo on whichever one ends up looking better. I got them primed, and I put a few shades of brown and gray onto the rubble. After a bit of dry brushing and some washes, we've got two decent bases. Back to painting Slambo. Here's our green friend compared to a vanilla Kragen painted in yellow. At the moment, that yellow is way more exciting. Slambo should be exciting, so we're gonna give him some dramatic, bright green highlights. I have here some Moot Green. This was one of the highlights on the box art Slambo. Also somewhere in here, I gave him bright red eyes, and I think they look sweet. As for the green, I'm going around and putting a bold edge highlight onto every piece of his armor. This is time consuming, but totally worth it. Increasing the contrast like this makes him more striking. It also makes the armor look more shiny and more metallic. Oh yeah, this looks cool. After Moot Green, I mixed in some more yellow and did a round of extreme Mountain Dew highlights. You can see that not only did I do the edges of the armor, I also did a center line on many of these segments. A lot of these armor plates have nice crimps in them, and these are good options for additional places to lay down a highlight. These truly are beautiful models. Sometimes you can really tell that the sculptors at Games Workshop designed them with painting in mind. I really enjoy the stark highlights on the midline crimps in the armor. These are helping my model to look more like the box art Slambo. I also went through and highlighted the steel with a bit of silver. Those ridges on the horns got highlighted too. The boots got highlighted, and they got a bit of stippling to make them look more like leather. While we're stippling leather, I used a slimy green to make some dots on the lizard hide. Slambo isn't even supposed to have a cloak, so I want this to be completely unobtrusive. It's doing a good job of hiding already, but I decided to give it some low-key highlights with midnight blue. Perfect. This won't stand out for any reason. I'm very happy with how Slambo is coming along, so let's snip him off of that temporary base and find a good perch for him. I tried out both of our possible bases before deciding on a winner and getting him glued on down. And there you have it. This is the modern Slambo. A fun little break from painting all that yellow to do some green. I'm still very happy with my choice of yellow for the big army, but this green is nice too, and variety is important. Compared to the previous Slambo model, you can see that he's been modernized, but it's still Slambo. That pose is a total classic, and the green I wound up with is close enough. I'm so happy that this line of Chaos Warriors got expanded a little bit with this warband. Alright, it's back to painting yellow. I'll keep adding to this army, and I'll check back in whenever I have a character or a monster that's worthy of their own video. There's a lot of good stuff coming up on the horizon that you'll want to be subscribed for. And I guess that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching.